I refined my text some more. I edited out everything that I did not want to include on the menu, and I got rid of any extra words or anything that didn't belong, and I got rid of all the hard returns. So what I'm going to do now, instead of manually formatting this entire block of text the same way that I did here, I'm going to go ahead and use some paragraph styles. So I'm going to the window menu, going to type, going to choose paragraph styles. And I want to make a paragraph style out of this header because I want to repeat it in these other places. So I'm going to select that header that I've already applied a style to, or I've already applied formatting to. I'm going to click on this little Create New Style button, and I'm going to let's name this Green Food Header. Okay. And then I'm going to create a style out of these prices. So I'm going to create a new style, and I'll name this. Now, when I select some text and I choose the paragraph style that I want to apply, so I'll go ahead and do that for the rest of the prices. All right, and then I'm going to apply the header style to the next header to be red. So I'm going to change that to red. And then I'm going to create a new style from that. That one. Red food header. All right, so now I can alternate these header colors. If I wanted to change the spacing between this pricing information and this text, then I would click on prices style. I could go to this options menu and choose paragraph style options. And then I could change the name if I wanted. I could try, let's try indents and spacing. So right now it's got a space before of 4 points. If I tried 6 points, it gives me a little bit more space there. I think I'm going to leave it at 4 though. An easy way to edit things. So you could even edit the font or the size, the color, that sort of thing. Another thing that I did was to format this specialty pizza head. And I used Minion regular 36 point size, and then I put a negative 30 tracking on that.